She is Linda Danielle
Thomas.
Edwards. Thomas. I had to do that because, you know, sometimes when you change your name and you grow up and get married, I just, you know, which one you were using this time? But we know she's a Thomas. She's been born a Thomas, she's been raised a Thomas, and she's going to come the way God has ordained her to be. I thank God that she traveled all the way from Germany Woo! To be with us on this day. Awesome word of God. She brought some friends which she'll introduce, and I'm just so excited about the word. Are you excited about the word? Are you excited about the word that's going to be from Germany that's going to drop here and be with us for a little bit while? Give your hands, put your hands together and give God some praise.
Of God has done a great work. I even bought some fruit back. You know when you go somewhere there, sometimes you bring some fruit back. Hallelujah! I bought some fruit in the house. First one amongst the many that I baptized, some Africans, Americans, my German, her husband. Hallelujah. Amen. God has been good, saints.
Yes.
See, it's one thing to go somewhere, but when you know God is in it, that would be increase.
Hallelujah.
That would be multiplication. Mm-hmm. So, without any further ado, what time it is?
Kingdom time. On the move. For Christ.
Somewhere.
We do something. We go somewhere else. Excuses. We move. God moves just like that.
Gang, everybody is people, whether they say they're Muslim or whatever. God is so good.
Yeah.
You see, when let me say something to some of y'all people that have been hid in the back or looked over, doubted, talked about all those things that a lot of us go through, rejected, all of us go through rejection. Mm-hmm. God, sometimes how you never go through much is given, much is required.
Right.
So when you go through your David or your Moses or whatever, your Josh, whatever season, whatever thing that God is taking you through, get ready. Because that's training ground.
Amen.
That's training ground, you see. Don't look at it about, what they did, why this happened to me, why not you? God is trusting you to bring you out so you can go and tell the story.
Yes. Amen.
How you made it over. I always said, you know, I thank God for the Bible because it's our guidelines and it teaches us, it tells us. But it's time for the saints to become the Bible.
Hallelujah.
It's time for us to become the living epistles. Ooh. It's time for us to take the word off the paper and eat it like he said. We're having communion, aren't we? Hallelujah!
Oh.
We're having communion today, right? Glory to God. So let me, I thank God, y'all have already heard the woman of God, one of my ministers, y'all already heard this, my and this girl, stand up, Bella, I'm sorry, I ain't gonna take too much of your time, but this lady here is a professional American football player from Africa in Germany, married to an engineer. She played football, y'all. They call her the Giant Tank. She hits you going down. But she's also one of my dancers, intercessor, praise leader, and I thank God for her. To increase after this one, he left me with big old holes in water. This is something that's by herself. So I just thank God, I thank God. I'm so blessed. I don't want to spend much time on that. I thank God for them being here. She's left me about 2-3 years ago now, but she still drove all the way to Boston. Mm-hmm. To be here. I thank God they sit down some time just to come. And that's because of the love. Hallelujah! And the top of family. Hallelujah! Glory to God. I want you to look at your program here. I speak real fast. I know, see, I'm not a New Yorker, so I mess up some words. Just in case. I mess up one or two, I talk to some of you to look at. Amen? I'm used to that. When I travel, I have to have an interpreter everywhere I go. When I go to Africa and Sri Lanka and those places, even in Germany, you know, I was preaching for 4 months, and the people were just doing like this. And so I saw the devil. I said, I just preached that. What's wrong with y'all? Why y'all getting into it? I looked at them one day, and they were, I said, y'all don't understand a thing I've been saying, have you? We ain't understood nothing you said for 4 months! So I had to get an interpreter. Amen? And they speak English. So I was messing up some words. Amen. So if I mess the thing up, you'll have the basic things that we're talking about today. Glory to God. I know you heard Matthew 26:17. Matthew being the first book. See, we talk about the New Covenant now, right?
Yeah.
Matthew's being the first book of the gospel in the New Testament. Two being a memorable witness. The Bible says on the second day he made heaven. And two or three witnesses everywhere you go always be. Six is the number for man. I heard Pastor say he had six mans in here. So that's a good number. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One is the number for unity. Time for saints to unify and come on together. Seven is the number complete or kingdom. And three is the number for preparation. And this is my little people here. No more drummer. I am tired of drum.
Yes.
It's time to rise for the occasion. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we read already, but I want Steve to stand right with you and read some more as I stop you and give you what God has given to me. It's time for us to go to another level. It's time for us to go to another dimension. It's time for us. It's time for us. See, we need to fill up these pews. The Bible said the sheep have got sheep. We wait on the pastor to do everything. No. If you check yourself, I don't care if you've been saved 1 year, 6 months. How many people have you told about Jesus?
Yeah.
How are you remembering him? Are you just coming on communion time and say, I remember? How? What you do every day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you're doing what God said do, somebody need to be following you. Somebody need to be following you. I don't care if it's just the way you stand. You ain't got to talk all the time. Everybody don't talk. But if he's inside of you, some residue will be coming out. Amen?
Yeah.
He said if you open your mouth, he'll speak for you. The Holy Ghost is contagious.
Yes, it is.
If you present it right, you see, when we said, let that kingdom come, we said it's kingdom time, what are we saying? He impregnated us with 9 fruits of the Spirit. Amen. He said, let that kingdom come on earth and in heaven. We are the urchins of the kingdom. Mm-hmm. You got to stop doing tit for tat. You got to stop somebody mad at you, you mad at them back. That ain't your assignment. Your assignment is to birth those fruits that he gave you. You have to learn how to look beyond their faults because they need you. And you're the carrier. It's time for us to carry the word. Amen?
Amen.
It's time for us when they get sadness, baby, you bring joy. The joy of the Lord is your strength.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Oh, there's confusion. You got to be. He said he shall your people the preparation of peace.
Hallelujah.
You got to believe this word. Stop just reading this word. Stop just quoting scriptures. We got to be the Bible.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. I thank God that I'm around this time. You see, because saints, it's palace time.
Hallelujah.
It's time for the saints to walk like the kings and the queens that they are.
Yeah.
It's when Joseph, see, Joseph went. He went through a lot of stuff. But baby, it's time for Christ. I was saying, we know Obama was sit there in the, on top of the world. The first black man, nobody believed. Black folks didn't put him there. White man didn't put him there. God put him there.
Right.
In your face. He came from nowhere. Nobody knew who he was. Mama told me she prophesied that as well. Nobody knew where he was, where he come from. God brought him. Maybe he hasn't died. Brought him to the sea. Amen?
Yes.
And we did what he had to do in the natural. But see, God, just like we got the Old Testament and the New Testament, God always do things in the natural before he do it in the spirit. Now in the spirit, for the people, the spiritual people of the Lord, it's time for us to rise and be put in the front. Let the last shall be first and the first shall be last. For those who have an ear to hear what thus saith the Lord.
Yeah.
It's sad and indictment. Some saints are going to be still broke down, poor, acting like they don't know for the rest of your life. It's a sad indictment to be a child of the Most High God. And keep calling your problems and stop. And now, all the promises he has made for you, you ain't claiming none of them. You read the scripture, but you don't walk it out. Hey, walk it out, walk it out.
Walk it out.
Walk it out, walk it out. This is God in me. What? Don't give me stuff. I'm serious. We got to know it's God in you.
Yeah.
You know, no cartoons give you, even they give you, I'm like the one. I got to move it, move it.
You got to move it, move it. We got to
move it.
We supposed to be like the wind, saints.
Yeah.
When people see us, that we can see the Holy Ghost moving and we want to be a part of it.
Amen.
Glory to God. Anyway, let's go. 17, one in unity, seven is complete. It's kingdom time. Seven means kingdom as well. That's why, come on, Dee, read for me.
Now, the first day of the feast of unleavened bread.
Understand, please, Dee.
The disciples came to Jesus saying unto him, where went thou that we prepare for thee to eat the Passover? And he said, go into the city to such a man and say unto him, the master saith, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at thy house with my disciples.
Stop right there. I like Luke as well. Luke says that there's a man in the city. It's in 22:9. I'm going to go there later. The man in the city with a pitcher of water in his hand. Every time you see water in the word, it means the word. Every time you see the word, that's why he washed away. The water symbolized the word. In other words, he said, there's a man in the city. See, this is a pre-type Christ-like. There's a man in the city with water in his hand. Follow him. Because he's going to take you to a place. Ha. Lean not into your own understanding. Ha. He said, listen. He said, don't worry. Because I'm prepared a place for you. Y'all know the John 14. Yeah. How? Wherever I go, ye shall go also.
Yes.
This is what he was saying way back then. He was teaching them, go and look for that man that's carrying the water. And he's going to take you to an upper room. Do y'all know you got an upper room? I know I got a mansion up there. You know you got an upper room? Hallelujah. Yeah. He said it was going to be ready and furnished. My God, Zion. In here, he's telling us to follow the word. Follow that man that's carrying the water. Follow that man that's going to have that place. It's already ready for you. Yes. My God, I got excited when I saw that shield. Yes. I said, God, you talking right there. He said, follow that man with the word. Follow your pastor. Yeah. He's going somewhere. Yeah. Follow him. He's teaching you where he's been. He's sitting here to give you the word. Yeah. Did y'all go to that thing on Thursdays? He's been doing that for a long time. He's been presenting the kingdom to his people a long time. He ain't just stuck doing that. Some people call it show out. But God showed out. If we want to be like God, show up and show out.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Amen.
Yeah. He didn't have to. Watch everybody wait like that. He has said, let there be light. That was a show out. He has said, depart the Red Sea.
Showing out.
Showing out. He didn't have to take his hands and put on the man. Oh, that was a show out. So when you were acting like, see, he was showing you a pre thing of what heaven would be like. When I got in the star, I'd be like this. When you know who you are, sometimes that intimidate people. But see, when I saw that star, they said, call my name. It might seem foolish to some, but I tell you, the wise man will help him get to what he's supposed to do.
Yeah.
Glory to God. People read.
And the disciples did as Jesus had appointed them, and they made ready the Passover. Now when the eve was come, he sat down with the 12. And they did eat, and he said, verily, I say unto you, the one of you shall betray me.
Stop right there. See, because we keep looking at how Judas betrayed Jesus. And he told them right before that, he said, the time is at hand. I'm telling you, saints, now the time is at hand. Not tomorrow. Amen. Now, just like now, faith, the time is at hand. I did a series on the Bible. I didn't like signs and biology and stuff like that, but since I've been in this word, my God. And one of them, I got to the talk to the hand, I did a message called talk to the hand. I found out this hand had 27 bones. Is that the New Testament? Mm-hmm. Then I found out the joints of it have 14 joints. I said, my God, Jesus came down 14 generations. Mm-hmm. So today, when he said the time is at hand, hallelujah. See, we have to realize this body, him, is the temple. And he made it a way. It didn't heal itself. If you'll talk to it, it came from dirt. If you'll speak to it, it will give you life. He said he came to life and life abundant, right?
Yes.
We have to know how to get that life. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Wait a minute. Portray. When you ladies, if you're single, if you got that man that's in the wrong place, you portray Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If that check or that money you hold it for tithes and offering, you portray Jesus. If you're not obeying your leadership, you might as well be like Judas. That's quite a sign. See, we look at those people in the Bible, they did this, but if we ain't following and we ain't obeying, if we ain't doing, we still betraying him. We might as well take a nail and hit him on the when we're not doing what we're supposed to do.
Yeah.
That's why the chairs are empty. See, people follow Muslims because they dress like they look like. They get them people follow. They follow Jehovah's Witness because they out there to rain, sleep, or snow. Knock on the door. How many times we have revivals? How many y'all show up? How many times we have prayer meetings? How about Bible study? How many was in Sunday school this morning?
Come on.
We got to get to this faithful walk.
Yeah.
Faithful. I got some Harans in my church that just got saved. And boy, I told them, let me tell y'all one thing. Don't you leave some of that stuff you learned with Muhammad. In the morning they pray. In the noon they pray. In the night they pray. The earth yields to what speaks the loudest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I said, you take that and be the redeemer of the Lord saying so. Keep a praying. Amen?
Yes.
Oh, it's quiet in Zion. But God's trying to take us to a place called there.
Yeah.
He's trying to take us to a place where we can be who we are. Listen, we sing these songs, I am a friend of God. You can be a saint, and you ain't made it to the friendship yet. Amen. When he called his disciples, they were servants. Yeah. They became sons, then they became friends. So you got to develop that.
All right.
If you ain't obeying my friend, no, you ain't a friend of God. You ain't ready for that yet.
Amen.
Because you ain't obeying. I come to church every Sunday, so does the devil.
Okay. Oh, that's what
hello, this is his biggest playground. He ain't worried about them out there. He's trying to get you up in here confused. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, keep it real.
And they were exceeding sorrow, and they began, every one of them, to say unto him, Lord, is it I?
Listen to that. We do the same thing. Instead of being ready. You know, just like Pastor said, he got AIDS. But everybody should be an A. It should be nothing happen. As long as you've been with St. John, right now, he should just step to him and preach. Everything, every distraction, everything should be done. Everything should be taken care of.
Amen.
And when the people walk through that door, you see, we as saints, I'm not talking to St. John, I'm talking about church, period. Because we the mess, religious folks have messed up folks more than anybody, any institution in the whole world.
Yeah.
If somebody come through that door, if all these saints in the house, before the altar has been called, if we're all on one accord, if we're all praying and praising God, they'll be healed right there.
Amen.
By the time altar call, we all be shot.
Yeah.
If we was in our position.
Yeah.
If we were on our post. But if we got to do maintenance on you every Sunday, yeah. Every Sunday you got this stuff. We got to pray for you all the time. Well, you ain't developed where you can be praying for somebody else. That's why we lose it in that area.
Right.
Now this ain't a beat down. This is a get up message. So don't let think I'm coming to beat you down because I'm talking to all of us.
Yes.
And none of us exempt from being used. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Keep it real.
And he answered and said, he that dippeth his hand with me in the dish, the same shall betray me. The Son of Man goeth as it is written of him. But woe unto the man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed.
Lukewarm Christians. He was called. Jesus chose you. He chose you. He was right at the table.
Sure was.
But he said, it's better that you not even be born again saved than to be lukewarm. If you're in St. John and you still ain't working yet, you might be getting lukewarm. If you're in St. John, you still ain't filled out with, you might be stale. Okay, y'all mad at me in St. John. If you was a king of Revelation,
hallelujah,
and you ain't found out what you're gonna be doing yet, and maybe you make it because you could be sitting in church backsliding.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. If you're mad with the pastor, if you ain't on one accord, you can backslide stuff more. Everybody keep going back to the back seat.
Yeah.
And then they be looking for you. You know, they came and some people leaving my church. I've been through some stuff, y'all. I can heavy persecution.
Yes.
When they was leaving the church, they came and they said, Pastor, so-and-so left the church. I said, oh, yeah, I know. He said, but these people don't leave the church. I said, maybe they left Jesus.
Yeah,
they left Jesus, and he looked at the rest of them. You gonna leave too?
Nah.
And I'm sorry. I'm not one. I made a mistake. I might be wrong, but until God say so, I came back and I had set everybody down because I was getting and trying to. I had a break. I'm now the founder of Kingdom Revelation. My first Lord, I was quick preaching for somebody else, so we had a split. So I was trying to get the people, God said, no, you're down for vision. You're the visionary. You supposed to give a vision, and the people is the pro-vision. So you done got off track. I said, wow. He said, yeah. He said, you're supposed to make it plain, the teaching's supposed to preach. So when they said, well, Pastor, Jesus left the 99 and went after the lost one. Lost one. Not the saints. Not the one that know already, not the lukewarm. He said the lost one. Now don't get me wrong. I go call him, but I ain't that strung out no more when I'm looking for everybody that know everything and then left the church.
Yeah.
Some of them need to leave the church. Ooh. Some of them just for season. Yeah. Some of them came for a reason. And some for a lifetime. You done heard all that before.
Yeah.
Even in your own relationship, you better know those ones for a lifetime. Yeah. Stop holding on to somebody that's supposed to be gone already.
Yes.
Just dead weight, baby.
Yes.
Let it go.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Let it go. Glory to God. I would rather lose somebody by telling the truth that would be sitting up making me a number in the church, and they one got the waist. They the one, you ever had a, what you call that?
Hang now.
The whole body hurt. Uh-huh. Hallelujah! Yeah, when one cell in the body ain't right, the whole body hurts.
Yeah.
So I'm looking for the healed body. I told him, I'm tired of dealing with chickens. You know chickens? They talk about anybody, know everything. God, ain't no way in the world. God said, be not a chicken.
Nah.
He said,
mount up. Hallelujah.
He gonna show off all of that mess. He ain't got time for that mess. All the time he come down is to pick up live meat.
Yeah.
Hey! Ooh. He don't even mess with dead meat. Glory to God. So I tell him, I'm looking for eagles in this season. This is season of more than enough.
Hallelujah.
I'm ready for mine. Hallelujah! Because sometimes when you hang with chicken too long, he will get you to fly. Hallelujah! Auntie told me a joke last night about the eagle failing the chicken, and he didn't know he could fly. And he was chick, chick, chick. And he kept saying, I believe I can fly, They said, you crazy. You had to tell you said, the Lord told me this. Thank you, Lord told you that?
Yeah.
You should have a Lord. Or even when they see it's the Lord, they start the hate game.
Yes.
Instead of praising God with you, they start hating on you. Yeah. The devil is alive this season.
Yes.
I said, find you some eagles and fly. Show it. Amen?
Yes.
Come on, finish.
Then Judah, which betrayed him, answered and said, Master, is it I?
The devil telling himself, you listen.
He said unto him, thou hast it. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and he blessed it.
Come on.
And he broke it. And he gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body.
Uh-huh.
And he took the cup and he gave thanks. And he gave it to them saying, drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament.
Come on now.
Which is shed for many for the remissions of sin. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth this fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out into the mountains.
See, hallelujah. Jesus wants us to come together in fellowship to remember.
Hallelujah.
He wants us to remember what he did.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He doesn't want us to get caught up in the part of being, you know, this is, why are you doing it? What are you doing it for? When you realize some of the things that he was saying are the parables he taught. He said, man should not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. He said, taste. I remember my grandmother used to say, oh, taste and see how good God is. Taste and see. Woo, Jesus. But I tell you, when I start eating this word, my.
Yes.
Woo, it's good.
Yeah.
It's good. The word is good all by itself. It gives you life and life abundantly.
All right.
When the doctor said, I got these blessed knees, and when I walk into the office, they said, we can't help you. They've been saying this since 1995. You need two knees. They shoot them up sometimes. They do all this other stuff. They keep them. We said, we just gonna keep giving you what you need because according to your x-rays, you don't supposed to be even walking. Let's know I'm running and standing on heels. You know what I tell them? Ah, you do what you do because Jesus already healed me. Now he says seek the physician, so if you got something wrong with you, don't be sitting around here with stuff growing on you. But I'm healed in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And if he's going, you can go see the doctor. Still say I'm healed. Don't get so holding it down till you ain't no earthly good. He sent them doctors here. Every ministry, that's ministry.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes I got some pills I take. I don't want to take them. 17 days I stayed up trying not to take sleeping pills. Because I don't want to be on my pills. But you know, he gave me this, what I call it kingdom energy. Hey! I don't know how to sit down. So I just have to accept God got healing and medicine too. Amen?
Amen.
Y'all don't hear me. I know y'all
yeah.
Want
yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. The bread of life. Yeah. Now let us get, we're here to do communion. But we got to understand this bread of life. See, the more you eat the word, you begin to look like the word.
Yes, yes.
My daddy said he was 75, and he's still alive. He can do it, right?
Yes.
See, I'm so blessed. I got it in my genes. My mama look good, she's 76. Mother mama look good, she's 75. 77, 74, huh? No worry about it. But I got a heavenly father. Hey!
Fire.
So when I tell my children over there, I run circles around them.
Mm-hmm.
Just like he do all the time. But I said, baby, I look in the mirror, 57 look good on you. Oh, hallelujah!
Amen.
But you know why? Because I'm eating the word.
Yeah.
He said he would come give you life.
And life
abundantly. We got to understand what that means. See, because when we impregnate ourselves with the nine fruit of the spirit,
uh-huh.
That means we can give life too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. When somebody's sad, baby, we got some love for you.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
When somebody's having a confusion, we got some peace for you.
Uh-huh.
Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
We got to realize what we're carrying.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
When addiction try to come and attack you, whether it's food, drugs, somebody else, baby, you got self control.
Yeah.
Hey, I like that one.
Mm-hmm.
Self-control. Yeah. So when you say you can't stop, the devil is alive.
Right.
If you're pregnant with those fruits of the spirit, you can do all things.
Yeah. Christ has truth.
Come on.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So we have to know the bread of life. Jesus is the bread of life.
Yeah.
But if you're a part of him, can't forgive. That ain't in the word. You can do that.